I believe Carrie is ready to rumble. You have a lovely lady in studio with you.
Yes,
Carrie, tell
indeed,
us who do you
I
have.
Do. So this morning we have Gabriella Bernard, filmmaker.
I am a filmmaker and I star in my own documentary.
Excellent. So your documentary, what's the name of it?
The name of it is Black Hair, and it's not like because my hair is black, the color black. It's because it's referring to natural hair that's not processed with chemicals or anything like that.
Yeah, because we're on the topic this morning of naturally me and, you know, just being yourself and being proud of who you are and just being, naturally yourself, right? So is it your first film?
This is my first film. I'm so excited. I actually worked aside Mikhail Gallofrey. He has a video and production company down here, and he does documentaries from time to time on different people. So he also has another documentary in the film festival that talks about domestic violence.
Okay.
And there was like a vagrant by Peaks that he went. He did a whole documentary on him. He cleaned him up, and now he's onto a better path. He's not like crazy and homeless anymore.
That's awesome.
It is.
Jeez. All right. So Black Hair, what was your motivation behind the film?
So basically, growing up, I was always made fun of.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you're a lovely young lady. I don't understand why people make fun of you.
No, well, people will tell me, you know, your head is too big, your teeth are too spaced out.
I got the big head thing too.
Yeah, it's like, really, you're going to make fun of me for something that I can't change? Like, I had no say in how big my head was or the texture of my hair. And it was in Trinidad, when you have hair like this, people assume that you're unprofessional. They assume that you're dirty. They assume that you just out of nowhere and you don't know how to act. And it's like, the texture of my hair does not define
who you
my professionalism.
Right.
That has nothing to do with it. And I reached a point where I said, you know, I'm fed up of the relaxer. I'm going to cut it off. And I was so proud of myself. I came to a point where Sasha Cosmetics, KFC, they were calling me to do ads for them.
Okay.
It was great. And then I ended up going on to Caribbean's Next Top Model with Wendy Fitzwilliam. And in the makeover segment, they decided to chemically relax my hair.
How did that, you know, how do you feel about that? Like, it couldn't
that
have been...
That hit me like a brick. If you saw the commercial for that episode, I was crying my eyes out. And it's not just hair. It's a part of who I am. It was a symbol of me loving myself again. And in this day and age, 2018, even though, okay, you want me to have straight hair?
Right.
Get a wig. You didn't have to chemically relax my hair because now, after the fact, I am still depressed about
it. Yeah, exactly. So you didn't have a choice in the matter?
I didn't have a choice.
You were sitting there and somebody just started putting these things in your hair?
No. They told me up front. They said, okay, so for you, we're going to relax your hair. And I was like, what? It's like, yeah, we're going to relax your hair. I was like, really? I had my hair processed for 15 years. I just started to grow back my hair. It's almost 3 years I'm growing it back natural. They're like, well, it's either you relax your hair or you get eliminated. You just pick one. And it really came down to me saying, did I come all this way to Jamaica to give up?
Exactly.
So I just sucked it up and I said, you know, let me see how far I make it.
Yeah, but that had to have been really hard, though.
It was.
I can't even imagine. I mean, I have no hair, so I don't really, I don't really know. But yeah,
no,
just
but
everything you stand for, you know, it had to have affected you a lot.
Exactly. And the irony is that the episode actually aired the same week that Black Panther premiered.
Right.
And that is all about black empowerment and loving ourselves and not trying to pretend to be something that we're not to fit into society.
Exactly.
And I think as an upcoming role model for the youth, I would want to motivate them to be their most authentic self.
Right.
So through my documentary, even though I speak about me having natural hair, me being comfortable with my natural hair, I also say that it's not an anti-campaign against anyone. If you want to wear a weave, you wear a weave. If you want to relax your hair, fine, you do you. You do what you're comfortable with.
Exactly.
But don't try and change who I am.
Right. So just tell us a little bit about the film, as much as you want to tell before it comes out.
Well, it's going to be at the Trinidad and Tobago Film Festival.
Right, and when does it premiere?
So it's premiering Friday the 21st of September at UWE at 5 o'clock. And then it has a second screening that same day at 6 in Movietown, Port of Spain.
Right.
The Monday, I think it is in Tobago, and Tuesday it is coming back to Movie Town San Fernando.
All right, great. Mm-hmm. What was your most memorable moment while creating the film?
Well, the most memorable moment was cutting my hair myself. So it was like long, and I took it, and I just snipped it off. It's
so
in
that,
the trailer
so
and
that
everything.
Was, so that was real. That wasn't like
no, that
know?
Was real. I was right. Like, I'm so fed up of this. This yeah. is not me. I'm not trying to be something I'm not. You know. Okay. And I'm really proud of it too, because it's not just Trinidad that it's screening in. It's actually been picked up in the States as well.
Right.
In July, it's screened in Washington, D.C. for Say It Out Loud Film Festival. And in Baltimore, Maryland, it's going to be at the Baltimore International Black Film Festival in
That's
October.
A lot to see. Baltimore International Black Film Festival. All right, great. That's awesome. So it's not only going to be here, it's going to be abroad as well. And, you know, everything it stands for. That's, whoop whoop for TT, Trinidad and Tobago. And to you, you know, for just bringing this awareness and all like that. So what message, before we wrap up, what message would you like to leave with us?
So I would just like to say that through my documentary, if I could help just one person live as authentically as possible, I would be so happy. Because we go through life trying to please everyone except ourselves, and we really need to put ourselves first.
All right, well, Gabriella, thank you for being here, and thank you for sharing with us. And, you know, I'm really looking forward to the premiere of your film. Hopefully I can catch it myself, you know, because I really appreciate what it stands for and everything like that.
Great.
You know, so thank you again for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Of course. So now we go over to Rishi.
Thank you very much, Carrie. And yeah, best of luck to you, Miss Bernard.